Welcome to the Cybersecurity Speaker Series, presented by NSA's Cybersecurity Collaboration Center. Our mission is to augment and amplify NSA's ability to prevent and eradicate threats to national security systems and the defense industrial base by establishing open, robust, and collaborative relationships across industry and government. Through bidirectional threat intelligence sharing and joint analytic tradecraft development, these partnerships leverage unique talents and capabilities to enhance cybersecurity across the nation. In this series, you'll hear about the work we do here and its real-world applications, bringing these insights to you through some of the top minds at NSA.
Welcome to the Speaker Series from NSA's Cybersecurity Collaboration Center. My name is Josiah Dykstra, and I'm a technical fellow here at NSA. In this series, we invite NSA experts to come share their insights and their expertise about the work going on here at NSA. Our topic for today is 5G. And with me are Natalie Pittore, the lead for the Enduring Security Framework, and Martin Goldberg, our lead for 5G standards. Thanks for joining me.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
So Martin, I think a lot of people have seen this phrase 5G on television, on their own devices, and so forth. Can you just start by level setting us? What is 5G?
Well, for the common consumer, 5G is really how they interact with their smartphone, their ability to stream media or do social media on their phone. But what makes 5G truly special is as an enabler technology for other types of products. So consider like smart cities or intelligent traffic systems. The importance of 5G is it's not a one-size-fits-all types of technology, where previously with 4G, it was only designed really for the user. With 5G, you can essentially give connectivity to traffic lights, where it doesn't need as much bandwidth as a smartphone was, because traffic lights aren't watching movies.
Right, exactly. That's a great intro. Thanks for getting us started there. Natalie, what is NSA's interest in 5G cybersecurity?
So very simply, 5G security is a critical component of national security. At NSA, we have a robust cybersecurity mission, and so it's a priority that 5G have all of the security baked into it from the very beginning. So in that development, in the deployment, because that's going to ensure our ability to have secure communications. And a lot of people may not know that we're also a combat support agency. So our mission is to ensure the warfighter can accomplish their mission. And you need reliable, trusted, secure communications in order to do that, which makes 5G a priority as part of our combat support mission.
Yeah, excellent. Martin, anything else in that area?
Sure. So during comparison to 4G, they had this term over-the-top application. So when it came to the DoD's use of 4G, all we really had to focus on was the handset and the application and essentially ignore the 4G network. With 5G, it actually becomes more part of the application itself. So we have to spend more time actually securing the 5G network.
That makes a lot of sense. Given the criticality of cybersecurity everywhere, not only in this very complex ecosystem, or especially here, what are the threats that we're protecting against, either in the devices or in the network themselves?
So when we assessed the threats to 5G infrastructure, we bin them into three categories: standards, supply chain, and then the actual infrastructure itself. Now, I'll do a brief introduction to standards because we have our 5G standards lead here with us. But what we're looking at when it comes to standards is, what is the potential influence that adversarial nations could have in the development of long-term security standards in those standards development organizations? And where do we need democratic nations to be active and proactive in the development of those standards so that we're ensuring that long-term security? But then another aspect of it that many may not know is the use of those optional controls that are recommended, so encouraging vendors to take that next step and not just doing what's mandated, but doing those optional security controls that increase our overall protection. Another aspect of it is the supply chain, and 5G is not immune to the myriad of supply chain attacks that are potentially out there. And this is something that is always been of concern to the US government, but obviously continues to be a high priority. And so two areas that we can take for an example there is the potential of acquiring and then using counterfeit parts. Counterfeit parts often mean poorer quality. Poorer quality could introduce increased risk, and so therefore undermining the security of your networks. Another aspect of it is actually deploying hardware or software that's already been compromised in their development and supply chain. That's why we need our developers focused on security as well, because you could potentially acquire a piece of hardware or software that you're unknowingly deploying into your network that is already compromised, that gives the adversary an outlet to gain malicious access. Now, lastly is the actual infrastructure, and there are a myriad of potential threat vectors when you're looking at the actual infrastructure. And so that could be legacy vulnerabilities, so those vulnerabilities that already exist in 3G and 4G that are then assumed by 5G. We're talking billions of devices connecting to this network. And so you have poor network security on your device. Let's say you don't patch, right? Mm-hmm. That could then introduce vulnerabilities into the infrastructure itself. But then you can get into those network slicing compromises, which is another component of 5G, or adversary interference and spectrum sharing. And so there's really a wide variety of it, which is why we're placing such an importance on security when it comes to 5G.
Yeah, that's a lot of layers of threat and a lot of areas to protect.
Absolutely.
So Martin, one of those layers obviously is standards. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about the role that standards play in ensuring cybersecurity for 5G.
Sure, but let me start off by explaining what standard development organizations are. Essentially, they're a forum for companies and even for government agencies to come together and come to a common consensus on how a technology should work.
Okay.
Without it, it really becomes a Wild West. Think of having a smartphone, it only works in a single country or even a single state. That really isn't practical to have multiple phones. When it comes to NSA, a lot of our security tends to be done after the fact, kind of bolt-on security. With 5G becoming part of the application, some of the applications it does is like vehicle smart cars, medical IoT being one of them. And you really need good quality of service. You have to trust that connection. You have to trust that message is getting through. When you do bolt-on security, you add variant to that, and you're not sure what you're going to get out of it. So we need to approach security on day one and actually be involved in standards body so that it's actually part of the equation and not something after the fact.
That makes a lot of sense, and I'm glad you're there to represent us.
Thank you.
Natalie, we've only really scratched the high-level surface of this topic. If people want to learn more about the work from the Enduring Security Framework or other things that NSA is doing, where can they find that?
So your first stop should be nsa.gov/cybersecurity. The program I run, the Enduring Security Framework, it's a partnership with industry and government where we work together and have been working together for the last few years to develop best practice guidance. So for instance, you can find a paper we issued on potential threat vectors to 5G infrastructure. And if you want to take action, there's actually a 4-part 5G cloud security guidance that we've issued and is available there on that website.
Great. Well, thank you both for being here and for shedding a little light on the work that we're doing.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Please be sure to watch NSA's Twitter account @NSA Cyber for the announcement of future episodes. See you next time.